Internal Revenue Service IRS Tax News. IRS holds additional weekend events July 23rd through 24th to help people with child tax credit payments and economic impact payments. Friday, Saturday events in several cities support eligible families. IR 2021-156, July 21st, 2021, Washington. The Internal Revenue Service and partners in nonprofit organizations, churches, community groups, and others will host additional events in several cities this weekend to help eligible families register for the monthly advanced child tax credit, the advanced CTC payments. So let me give a quick recap on the CTC payments, the advanced child tax credit payments. Hopefully they're fairly straightforward for most people and you don't have to do much to set them up, but the IRS is making a big push to make sure that people that are eligible for them have access to them, and they're also setting up resources to try to deal with and get in front of typical problems that happen with these advanced kind of payments, which is a tool they've been using fairly often recently as they've been pushing out these new kind of things to try to help people out during the pandemic time period, and also tools that will help people to make any kind of changes that they might need to make with regards to where the payments go and changes to or electing into the payment or out of the payment and so on. So the advanced child tax credit, in essence, they increased the advanced child tax credit for tax year 2021, which you normally wouldn't get except for the fact that they made part of it advanced. You normally wouldn't get it until you file the tax return by April 15th, 2022. In order to make some of it advanced, meaning pay it in 2021, they made more of it refundable. That'll make it a little bit easier for them to calculate it. Refundable, meaning that you would get more of the credit even if your tax liability is basically zero, or the credit would go beyond zero. So it's more of a benefit program at that point rather than kind of a refund point. But it makes it easier to calculate or estimate what the credit will be without actually filing the tax return, allowing them to send out part of the credit in the advanced payment format. So then what they did, you can imagine them trying to figure out what the tax credit would be based on the prior tax years, 2020, 2019, or any information they might have gotten from you for the other kind of resource, which is the non-tax filing tool resource. They can then take that, cut it in half, in essence, I believe is what the calculation will be. Then they want to allocate that half over the last part of 2021 with advanced payments, sending out monthly checks for the next 6 months. Therefore, they took that half of the child tax credit, divided it by six, and they wanted to send that out over the next 6 months. Now, this should be fairly straightforward for us on the taxpayer side, because if you filed your taxes for 2020 or 2019, if not 2020, then the IRS should have the information for the dependents and should be able to process this fairly easily. But the IRS wants to make sure that they can reach people that possibly are not filing the taxes. Note that these kind of benefits are increasing the need for lower income people that may not normally need to file the taxes if they don't owe any taxes to want to file taxes, because now they might be eligible for the CTC, child tax credit, earned income tax credits, and the economic impact payments, which are all kind of tied to the tax return. So that's their major push to get those people involved. They also have the resources out there for kind of problems that you can foresee with this advanced payments, which would include, what if, for example, my 2020 tax return had a dependent, which is not going to be on my 2021 tax return because I have joint custody or something like that. And basically, that means that they might give it an advanced payment when I shouldn't be getting it in certain cases. And you might be able to go on and say, don't give me the advance payments. Or you might go on and say, I don't want to get the advance payments because I'm moving around and I don't want you to send it to the wrong address. Or you might have a situation where basically they're sending it to a wrong address and you want them to send it to a new address or change your banking or routing number from the last time you filed your tax return to send it to another account. These are all problems that we can kind of foresee at this point. And they're giving tools to hopefully pick up some of those problems as well. Okay, so this is focusing in on people that are helping others with the CTC credit. So if you're doing that, you probably want to get familiar with these kind of terms, the advanced child tax credit. Most people are going to be familiar with the child tax credit. They updated the child tax credit. They cut it in half. They're sending out monthly payments. We want to make sure that people are signed up for them and make sure that that they're sending it to the proper address and whatnot if you are eligible. So the special event, there's a link to the special event here on July 23rd through 24th, 2021, will be hosted by IRS and partner groups to help people file income tax returns and register for the advance payments. Events will be held in Birmingham, Alabama, Bronx, New York, Charlotte, North Carolina, Chicago, Illinois, Cleveland, Ohio, Dallas, Texas, Indianapolis, Indiana, Memphis, Tennessee, Minneapolis, St. Paul, Minnesota, Newark, New Jersey, New Haven, Connecticut, Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, Paterson, New Jersey, Riverside, California, Seattle, Washington, and Tampa, Florida. So if I mispronounced any of those, I apologize. There will be a link to this if you want to check on that link, and you can check out the names here yourself if they're interested in them. With the help of a new non-filer sign-up tool, so there's a link to the non-filer tool on the IRS website. Volunteers and IRS employees will assist eligible individuals and families get these important tax credits and benefits. So the non-filer sign-up tool is probably one of the go-to tools they're going to be using at these kind of events, because that's the most basic sign-up thing that you can do. It's kind of a step down from filing a very basic tax return. Note that if you're helping someone with these kind of things, or if you're looking into these kind of things yourself, the general questions would be, okay, is this person filing a tax return? If they are not filing a tax return, then they may not, you know, they may qualify for these things, such as the child tax credit, the earned income tax credit, and the economic impact payments, and not getting access to them. Next question is, well, what should they do at that point? Should they file the tax return? The question would be, well, are they required to file a tax return or not? If they're required to file a tax return and they just didn't file a tax return, then they should still file the tax return and not use the non-filer sign-up tool, because that'll just confuse the IRS. What you do in that point is file the tax return so the IRS has the information to process it. If they have not filed the tax return and they don't need to file the tax return because their income is below a certain threshold, therefore they're not going to owe any taxes, therefore the IRS is not going to go after them for not filing a tax return, because they don't owe any money to the IRS and the IRS is not trying to collect on taxes, then they still have the question as to whether they would benefit from filing or not. And you would expect that most people at these types of events would be in this type of situation. So in that situation, you're not required to file, but do you want to file your taxes, or do you want to use the non-filer sign-up tool? A lot of people would still benefit by actually filing a tax return, which is free, and there's free, you know, tax software out there that you can get access from the IRS website if your income is below a certain threshold, because you might qualify for other benefits that you wouldn't get access to if you use the non-filer tool, the big one being the economic or the earned income tax credit. So if they have any earned income, then they might qualify for an earned income tax credit. So in that case, you might still say, well, it would be beneficial to file the tax return. Now, obviously, the most basic thing that we can do, a level down from filing the tax return, is this non-filer sign-up tool, which should give people access to the basic information, even below just a basic tax return, to give the IRS the information necessary to process the child tax credit, the advanced child tax credit, hopefully, and hopefully the economic impact payments as well. Round 1, 2, and 3, I believe, can still all be accessed, I believe, with this non-filer sign-up tool, even though the first two rounds of the economic impact payments, kind of before they were saying you had to file the tax return and claim the recovery rebate credit, and the third one was the one they kind of aimed for this tool for. Now I think they're saying that you may get access to all three. So in any case, the major difference between the two, if someone doesn't need to file and they're deciding if they want to file a basic tax return or use the non-filer sign-up tool, the major benefit program that they would probably not have access to, that they might have access to if they use the non-filer tool instead of filing a tax return, is the earned income tax credit, I believe. So that's kind of the breakdown of it. So this tool, an update of last year's IRS non-filer tool, is also designed to help individuals register for the $1,400 third round of economic impact payment, also known as the stimulus checks, and claim the recovery rebate credit for any amount of the first two rounds of economic impact payments they may have missed. Individuals do not need to have children to attach these to attend these events and sign up for the economic impact payments. So if someone goes to these events, you might say, well, I don't have children. Do I, you know, should I still go to these events to see whether they can sign me up from the economic impact payment or something like that? You could still go. I mean, they could still go there because you'd still have access, possibly, even if you don't have access to the child tax credit, which you would need children for, you normally, right? You could then maybe get access to the economic impact payments. And so it might still be beneficial to do that. So if you're working at one of these kind of events, then you want to kind of know that terminology, right? You got the economic impact payments, first round, round one and two, now are something that you would have had to file the tax return for usually before, which was called the recovery rebate credit in order to get the first two rounds of the economic impact payments. But now they're saying if you file the non-filer tool, you may still have access to them. So they may be called recovery rebate credits, are the same things as the stimulus checks or the economic impact payments. Round three economic impact payments is not out yet in terms of recovery rebate credit because it's tied to the 2021 tax return. It's another prepayment type of thing that won't, you know, be a recovery rebate credit really until the filing of the tax return in 2022. Okay, so this is part of a larger effort underway at the IRS to reach people eligible for the payments and other credits. The IRS also continues working with partner groups across the country, both inside and outside the tax community, to share information and raise awareness. These activities and events are in addition to this special weekend of activities. This is part of a wider effort to raise awareness of the expanded child tax credit. The IRS also encourages its partners to use available online tools and toolkits, there's a link to those here, to help non-filers, low-income families, and other underserved groups sign up to receive the AdvCTC, the Advanced Child Tax Credit. People can check their eligibility for the advanced payments by using the new Advanced Child Tax Credit Eligibility Assistant. There's a link to that here. For this weekend's events, people are encouraged to have the following information when they come to one of these events. One, Social Security numbers for their children. Two, Social Security numbers for tax identification numbers for themselves and their spouse. Three, a reliable mailing address. Four, an email address. Five, the bank account information if they want to receive their payments by direct deposit. That's the basic information you need to get these types of benefits because, of course, the IRS sees you as a number, so they need your number, identification number, so they know who you are. They need the numbers of the qualifying children, which would be their identification numbers, and they need a mailing address typically, especially if they're going to be mailing the check out in the form of a mailed check and or a bank account number if you want your payments to be in the form of a bank account. And obviously, the bank is usually often better. Like if you're working with people that are moving around and whatnot, it would be nice if you could set up a bank account. Not always possible, but a bank account that kind of moves around, if you've got, that'd be easier. So some tax credits, such as the child tax credit, the CTC, are refundable, quote, refundable, meaning that even if taxpayers don't owe income tax, the IRS will issue them a refund if they're eligible, but they must file a tax return or register with the new non-filer sign-up tool to receive it. So that means, you know, it's that refundable portion. That's another kind of key phrase words you probably want to just know. It's refundable, meaning that you get, it's kind of like a benefit program if your income tax is below a certain amount. It's not really a refund. Refund is kind of a false term in those circumstances because there's nothing being refunded. It's a benefit program at that point in time, but they still use the term, you know, refund. So some people who haven't filed 2020 tax return yet are also eligible for the $1,400 per person economic impact payments and recovery rebate credit. The first monthly payment of the expanded and newly advanced CTC child tax credit from the American Rescue Plan were made on July 15th and will be sent monthly through December 15th. Most families began receiving monthly payments without any additional action. Eligible families will receive a payment up to $300 per month for each child under age 6 and up to $250 per month for each child ages 6 through 17. So when you're talking about the credit, you can kind of break it down at a month-by-month amount, $300 to $250 per child based on the age group, $250 to $300. And or if they have more questions, you know, the real kind of process you want to think of is, well, if you would have filed the tax return in 2021 or when you file it, you will have the advanced child, you'd have the child tax credit, which would have been increased, which you could figure out the increase. But just to note, it's been increased. It's been more of it's refundable than half of it was cut in half. And then they took that half, divided it by six, allocated it out for the next 6 months. And that's where they get to these 250 and the 300. If somebody asks, well, what's going to happen when I file the tax return? Because last year I get a refund of like $2,000 per child when I file the tax return and whatnot. It might not be that big, the refund, but you actually still should get a refund when you file the tax return, because I believe they only took half of the increased child tax credits. And so you may still get, you should still get something, you would think, then at the time you file the tax return for 2021 in 2022 by April 15th. So people who need to file a 2020 federal income tax return but are unable to attend one of these events may be able to prepare and file their own federal income tax online using the free file if their income is $72,000 or less. There's a link to that free file here. People who don't need to file a 2020 federal tax return can also use the non-filer sign-up tool. There's a link to that here to register to receive the advanced CTC, child tax credit payments, the third round of the economic impact payments, and the recovery rebate credits, which are the first two rounds of the stimulus checks, in essence. And the IRS encourages people to request payments via direct deposit, which is faster and more secure than other payment methods. It's also easier on the IRS too. But it is better method, typically faster, more secure. That's true. People who don't have a bank account should visit the Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation. There's a link to that here. Website for details on opening an account online. They can also use the FDIC's bank fine. There's a link to that here to locate an FDIC insured bank. There's also more links to the bank online, American Bankers Association, Independent Community Bankers of America, National Credit Union Administration, and the Veterans Benefits Banking Program if you want to look at those links. About the advanced child tax credit. The expanded and newly advanceable child tax credit was authorized by the American Rescue Plan enacted in March. Normally, the IRS will calculate the payment based on a family's 2020 tax return, including those whose use the non-filer sign-up tool. So advanced means they have to do it before they actually file the tax return, meaning they have to rely on the prior year tax return, which would be 2020. But if they don't file the tax return, you can use this non-filer sign-up tool, which is the basic information. If that return is not available because it was not yet filed or is still being processed, the IRS will instead determine the initial payment amounts using the 2019 return or the information entered using the non-filer tool that was available in 2020. To make sure families have easy access to their money, the IRS is issuing these payments by direct deposit as long as current banking information has previously been provided to the IRS. Otherwise, people should watch their mail for their mailed payment. To learn more about the advanced CTC child tax credit payments, visit irs.gov/child tax credit 2021 or see FAQs, frequently asked questions on the 2021 child tax credit and advanced child tax credit payments. There's a link to those items here, and there'll be a link to this in the description.